minus 2. If I write x cubed minus 3x. If I write y square plus 2y minus 1. If I write t square plus 3t minus 7. All these are polynomials. In first three examples, the variable coming is x. Variable is x. Fourth example, variable is y. Fifth example, variable is t. Generally, we are denoting a polynomial by using the letter p, and in bracket we will write the particular variable. So if I write p bracket x, we can read it as p of x. It is the representation of a polynomial. So p of x is equal to x minus 3. This is p of x is equal to x square plus 5x minus t. It is p of x is equal to x cube minus 3x. It is p of y is equal to this much. This is p of t is equal to this. So on the basis of the variable, we are writing the name of the polynomial. So for representing a polynomial, we are generally using p bracket, the concerned variable. P bracket is the concerned variable. Okay, now? So now I am taking x minus 3. P of x is equal to x minus 3. See, I am taking x here, x here. I am putting like this, giving different values. For x, I am putting 0. P of x, which is P of x, x minus 3. When x is equal to 0, it is 0 minus 3. What is 0 minus 3? Minus 3. If I put x is equal to 1, 1 minus 3 is minus 2. If I put x is equal to 2, 2 minus 3 is minus 1. If I put x is equal to 3, 3 minus 3, 0. Or if I put 4, 4 minus 3, 1. If I put 5, 5 minus 3, 2. If I put negative 1 minus 3 is negative 4. If I put negative 2 minus 3 is negative 5. Okay, now? So, if we get any polynomial like this, if we get any polynomial, we can put the substitute values for x, we will get the corresponding values for the polynomial p of x. So, that we can tell, minus 3 is p of 0, minus 1, minus 2 is p of 1, minus 1 is p of 2, 0 is p of 3, 1 is p of 4, like that. Okay, so when we substitute some value for the corresponding variable, we will get a value, it is p of something, or if we put x is equal to k, what answer we are going to get? It is called P of K. Now you see, out of this, when we got 0, when we got 0, if we put x is equal to 3, if we put x is equal to 3, we got P of 3 is equal to 0. Then, this x is equal to 3 is called as the zero of the polynomial. So, in this chapter, we are using this important zero of the polynomial. So, what is meant by zero of the polynomial? If we put some value for the variable, for what value we are going to get zero as the answer? 0 is the answer. That particular value is called as the 0 of the polynomial. Okay. So, take down this table also. Take down this table. Then, you write the heading 0 of the polynomial. 0 of the polynomial. Write the definition. A real number K is said to be, a real number K is said to be a zero of the polynomial if P of K is equal to 0. Zero of the polynomial P of X if P of K is equal to 0. Once again I am telling, a real number K is said to be a zero of the polynomial P of X if P of K equal to 0. If P of K equal to 0. So this is important. When we are able to tell a particular number, a particular real number will be a 0 of the polynomial. So take down this table and the concept 0 of the polynomial.